Within Vanuatu is one of the most potentially dangerous volcanoes in the region, the volcano known as Ambae. Although technically a shield volcano, Ambae's eruptions are almost universally explosive. What makes this volcano so dangerous are the three acidic crater lakes it has at its summit, which have a pH as low as 2.3. With little or no warning, a large amount of one of these lakes could drain, whether it be through a newly opened fissure that acts like a hole in a water-filled bucket, or through explosion-induced acidic overflow of the caldera. Such a disaster occurred in 1916, destroying an entire village on the island's southeast. Additionally, due to the highly acidic nature of the three crater lakes, whenever the volcano does erupt, it creates large amounts of acid rain. Although Ambae has not been erupting for several months, this fact might change in the short-term future. On November 15th at 1 p.m. local time, satellite imagery detected a greatly increased amount of sulfur dioxide originating from the volcano. This most likely coincided with an increase in hydrogen sulfide emissions, causing a distinct sulfur smell to be detected amongst some of the island's several thousand residents. Additionally, these changes occurred alongside not only an increase in volcanic earthquakes, but local residents also reported the sounds of explosions, although no ash emissions were detected. In other words, the Ambae volcano is showing a greatly increased amount of unrest, possibly indicating that a new, shallow batch of magma is on the move underneath its most active central vent. Although all of this activity suggests that a new eruption might begin in the near future, the alert level of the volcano on the 0 to 5 scale has remained at 2, as this is the highest possible number that can be reached when the volcano is not erupting. For context, the Ambae volcano is located in central Vanuatu, where it is 265 kilometers north-northwest of the capital city of Port Vila. Like the more than a half dozen other volcanoes in Vanuatu, Ambae exists due to a tectonic plate collision to the west of the island. There, the Indo-Australian plate is subducting underneath the New Hebrides plate. The melted material from this collision then migrates upwards until it erupts onto the surface, forming a chain of volcanic islands and submarine volcanoes. The reason why the island of Ambae is elongated relates to the axis of two prominent rift zones on the volcano. One goes to the east-northeast, and the other goes to the west-southwest. These have been the site of many flank eruptions from cinder cones and more explosive Mauran tuff cones closer to the shoreline. Just like at volcanoes in the Hawaiian island chain, eruptions which start at the summit can propagate dozens of kilometers away into the volcano's rift zones, erupting elsewhere on the island. However, flank eruptions in recent times have been rare, as eruptions have generally occurred in the volcano's complex caldera. Ambae's summit contains a cluster of Mars and volcanic craters which lie inside not one, but two overlapping calderas. It is not known whether these calderas formed as a result of highly explosive Plinian eruptions like seen at the Ambrim volcano, or effusive flank collapse like seen at Kilauea. Regardless, in recent years, a low-lying vent has built itself up through Sertsayan-style explosive eruptions often seen at shallow submarine volcanoes, expanding into an island within the central lake. Developing from a tuff cone to a broad volcanic cone over several years, this feature is the most likely site for Ambae's next volcanic eruption and the source of the current sulfur dioxide emissions. Any new eruption will be likely to be moderately explosive, ejecting bombs of lava and fragments of rock over a several kilometer radius in addition to ejecting quantities of ash. For now, a 2 kilometer exclusion zone is in place around the aforementioned vent. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my patron, Dr. Stu, for supporting this channel.